In this lesson, we'll explore how Google Analytics collects and reports information about your traffic sources. We'll also cover how you can track your marketing campaigns. Let's think back to creating a measurement plan. One step was to identify the key segments for your business. A common set of segments that almost every business needs to measure is marketing campaigns, the traffic-driving initiatives that bring customers to your site. Being able to identify these campaigns and traffic sources in reports allows you to tie your marketing investment to conversions and revenue. For each user that comes to your site, Google Analytics automatically captures a number of attributes or dimensions about where the user came from. Two such dimensions are source and medium. The source is the name of a website that referred the user to your site. For example, if a user clicks over to your site from Google Search, the source will be Google. The medium is the mechanism, or how the user got to your site. For example, if a user clicks over to your site from an unpaid search result, the medium will be organic. Google Analytics detects three mediums without any customization. The first default medium is organic. It represents traffic that comes from organic or unpaid search results. Another default medium is referral. Any traffic that comes to your site from another website that's not a search engine will show up in your reports as a referral. The final default medium is none. This medium is applied only for users that come directly to your site by either typing your URL into a browser or clicking on a bookmark. In your reports, you will see these users have a source of direct and a medium of none. But what about your other channels, like social media campaigns, email campaigns, banner ads, and other programs? How do these show up in Google Analytics? To track campaigns in Google Analytics, you use a process called link tagging. Link tagging is adding extra information to the links that users click on to get to your site. This extra information that you provide is stored in campaign tags and overwrites the default categorization that would normally be assigned to the incoming traffic. For example, let's say you send a monthly newsletter to your customers. The newsletter has links that go to your website. Adding campaign tags to these links allows Google Analytics to identify that the user came from an email campaign. There are five campaign tags that you can use. You'll usually use at least three when tagging links. The source and medium tags allow you to overwrite the source and medium that would ordinarily get set by default. For the newsletter, you might set the source to July News and the medium to email. Another campaign tag is called campaign. Use this to name your marketing campaigns. For the newsletter, you might set this to summer sale. You should always use the campaign, medium, and source tags when tracking a campaign. The last two campaign tags are optional, term and content. Term identifies the keyword for paid search campaigns. The content tag can be used to differentiate versions of an ad. For example, if you have two different versions of an email newsletter, you can use the content tag to differentiate visits from newsletter version 1 and newsletter version 2. So why is link tagging so important? Let's say we have two versions of a display ad. And let's assume that both ads are running on the exact same site. The first ad does not have any campaign tags, but the second ad does. When users click on the first ad, they will be identified as referrals coming from the website hosting the display ad. Google Analytics will not collect any campaign information because there were no tags. When users click on the second ad, they will be identified as coming from a named campaign because the ad contained the campaign tags. So you can see, if you don't tag your campaigns properly, it can lead to incorrect data in your reports. You can use a tool called the URL Builder to learn how to construct your campaign tags correctly. The tool can be found in the Google Analytics Help Center. To use the URL Builder, first enter the destination URL for your ad, which is just the URL where you want a person to land. Then, enter the values you want for each campaign tag. Use consistent spelling and capitalization when entering tag values. Since Google Analytics is case sensitive, a campaign named Promo1 in all uppercase will show up separately from a campaign named Promo1 in all lowercase. Also, standardize on consistent values for your specific mediums, like CPC for cost per click, social for social media activities, and display for your display ads. The URL builder can only construct one URL at a time, so you probably won't want to use it to construct every URL for every campaign. If you have a large number of URLs to tag, you can use a spreadsheet to simplify the process. Spreadsheets with an embedded formula can make it easier to generate thousands of tagged URLs quickly. Now let's briefly talk about tracking traffic from Google AdWords. Google Analytics and Google AdWords are connected, so there's no need to manually add campaign tags to your AdWords links. AdWords auto-tagging automatically populates the five dimensions that we previously discussed: campaign, medium, source, content, and keyword. In addition to these dimensions, auto-tagging also imports other dimensions specific to AdWords campaigns, like keyword match type and the ad placement domain. By default, AdWords auto-tagging is enabled for your account. So far, we've talked about how to tag and identify traffic from individual campaigns, sources, and mediums. But what if you want to bundle some of these activities together to better reflect how you manage your marketing strategy? Channels in Google Analytics allows you to organize rule-based groups of traffic based on your own campaigns, keywords, sources, or mediums. For example, let's say that your email, search, and display marketing teams have created a joint campaign strategy for a summer promotion. You could define a channel called Summer Promo that groups these coordinated activities together for analysis in your reports. Google Analytics automatically recognizes several predefined channels. Some examples of predefined channels are direct, email, social, organic, and display. These channels are all part of the predefined basic channel grouping. You can create your own channel grouping and redefine these channels according to your own needs. And you can define your own additional channels and add them to the basic grouping or to your own custom groupings. Now let's look at where campaign information shows up in your reports. To view your data by source and medium, use the All Traffic report. This report includes all the sources and mediums you used in tags, as well as default mediums like organic and referral. Data for your campaigns is in the Campaigns report. Here you can see the data for each campaign you used in tags, as well as for each AdWords campaign. Keywords that you've tagged will show up in the Paid Search Keywords report. Finally, information from the content tag will also appear in the campaigns report. However, to see traffic by content, you need to change the primary dimension to add content. Remember, the campaign tags create standard Google Analytics dimensions, so you can use these dimensions in many other features, like custom reports, custom dashboards, unified segments, etc. How your marketing campaign data appears in your reports impacts how well you can measure the success of your business. Be sure to establish best practices within your organization to make sure your campaigns are tagged consistently. Now it's your turn to practice creating campaign tags. Complete the activity in this lesson to apply what you've learned.